Warning: read and follow all labels and the owner's manual.
Hi, my name's Ethan Rosler. I'm a welding engineer here at Miller Electric. Today, we are here to talk about common issues you might encounter when MIG welding aluminum. Porosity, smut, burn through, lack of fusion, and hot cracking are some of these common issues. Let's dive into our first topic, porosity. Porosity is a common issue in aluminum MIG welding. To reduce or eliminate the porosity in your welds, there are a few things to keep in mind. Aluminum forms an oxide layer when it's exposed to oxygen. This is a porous layer that has a higher melting temperature than the aluminum beneath it. It can trap contaminants like moisture, oil, and grease in it. Aluminum should be dry when you're getting ready to weld it. Avoid big swings in temperature, which can cause condensation. This condensation is a common source for hydrogen, which is soluble in molten aluminum. If your aluminum is damp, heating the material up to 150 degrees Fahrenheit can help drive off the moisture and is safe to do with most aluminum alloys. It is important to clean the material using a solvent first to make sure that there are no oils or greases present, as they're a source of hydrogen. Next, use a grinder, a stainless steel wire brush with light pressure, or chemical means to remove the oxide layer. Welding with higher currents, which can be accomplished by increasing your wire feed speed or wire diameter, will allow for a more fluid weld pool. This can provide more time to allow the gaseous hydrogen to escape before it's trapped in the form of porosity. Adding helium to your gas mixture can also help reduce trapping porosity in your welds. The additional heat that it provides will allow more time for the hydrogen to escape. If you want to check your results after implementing these best practices, a fillet break test is an easy and cheap way to test your progress. Smut on the surface of the weld bead is a common issue with 5000 series filler metals. It is a magnesium oxide that forms on the surface of the bead. It looks like black soot covering your weld. This issue is common with 5000 series filler metals because magnesium is the main alloying element. 4000 series filler metals, whose main alloying element is silicon, do not experience this problem to the same extent. Excessive voltage is a common cause of smut. Using a lower voltage or arc length can help reduce it. Using a 5 to 15 degree push angle is ideal. This allows for the cleaning action to take place in front of the puddle. Dragging the weld doesn't allow this cleaning action to take place and causes smut. Burn through is caused by welding with too much heat for the material you are welding on. You can fix this by lowering the wire speed, which lowers your current. Also, you can lower your heat input by traveling faster. Another way to help with burn through is pulsing. It can help you lower your heat input. Due to the high thermal conductivity of aluminum, it is important to make sure that you have enough heat to create proper fusion. Lack of fusion can be caused by your current being too low. You can increase your currents by increasing your wire feed speed or increasing your wire diameter. Lack of fusion can be caused by aluminum oxide on the base material. Cleaning your material is critical. This oxide has a higher melting temperature than the rest of the base material. It can act like a barrier, which can prevent proper fusion. Shielding gas selection can also help with this issue. Adding helium to your gas mixture can provide more heat when it ionizes. Due to the high thermal conductivity of aluminum and higher melting temperature of aluminum oxide, this extra heat will provide broader penetration, which will ensure fusion. Another place lack of fusion can occur is at the start of your weld. Using a hot start can help reduce the chance of this happening. Hot cracking is caused by crack-sensitive bead profiles, using the wrong filler metal, or crack-sensitive chemistries in the molten weld pool. A common location for hot cracks to occur is in the crater of your weld. These are referred to as crater cracks. A common fix is to re-trigger and fill in the crater with a short weld. A more consistent and more efficient option is setting a crater parameter on your welder. When welding aluminum, a concave bead profile can increase your susceptibility to hot cracking. As you can see in this example, the concave bead on the left cracked, but the bead with proper convexity on the right has not. This kind of cracking can also be seen in root passes that are thin and concave. Hot cracking occurs because the base material and filler metal freeze at different rates. If the base material solidifies before your filler material, it can cause stress on your weld before it solidified. If you're having crack problems, crack sensitivity curves are a good resource. As you can see in this chart, when small amounts of common aluminum alloying elements are added to aluminum, the crack sensitivity increases dramatically. This is why common filler metals have high alloy percentages. 4943 and 4043 have between 5 and 6% silicon, and 5356 has between 4.5% and 5.5% magnesium. Dilution of your filler metal and base material while you are welding is also important. Even if you use the proper filler metal, if you don't have enough dilution, you may end up with an alloy percentage near the crack sensitivity peaks. Referencing Hobart's filler metal selection chart is the simplest way to ensure you are using the correct filler metal for the material you are welding on. To learn more, visit millerwelds.com/aluminum.